Okay, sorry about that interruption. So we were talking about the systems of registration, where we said we've got the manual system, we've got the automatic system, and the express check-in system. Now, the express check-in system is where the guest is able to check in themselves. You know, we've got automated digital machines. When guests arrive and they're able to check in and go directly into their rooms. Okay, now we've got what we call the room status. Now, room status, when guests have come and stayed in our hotel for some time, they will need the reservation desk will need to find out, what is our room status? How many are we expecting, or how many are actually checking out? So this department will continue updating this information into the system, giving details of all those people who have occupied, those ones who are living, etc., etc. Okay. Now, of course, when the guest comes in, the reservation desk is able to issue the room keys, so the room keys are issued at the front office. However, this is a things have actually changed. From now, we no longer have the key, we have the smart card. Now, a smart card is just a something that looks like an ATM that a guest is able to swipe in, and they are able to open their rooms. Okay, so we've got those kinds of information. Okay, so we've got the room and the rate assignment. So the hotel normally identifies the room preference and the guest, and they will normally allocate a room for the existing depending with the category that is available. So we've got different room rates. Okay, the room rates are where we say the pricing. The hotel shall keep in mind that rate should be between a minimum determined by the cost and a maximum determined by the competition structure. Okay, so when we talk about minimum, we say there are certain rates that we will never charge below, and there are certain rates we will never charge above. So it is therefore important for the person who is handling this research, I mean the front office registration desk, to ensure that they're able to give the correct rate for the different rooms that are available. Okay, so we've got something that we call a rack rate. A rack rate is a price that is normally charged for a room before any discount has been offered. So this is a rate that is charged before any discount is employed. Okay, now we've got different factors that would affect the room rate. One, we say it is the season. You know, the season when it is high peak, the rooms are also very expensive. When it's off peak, the rooms are a bit moderate. Okay, so what affects the rates of rooms are is the season, the service level, the room location. Because sometimes you can hear a guest saying they want to have a room that faces the pool or faces certain location. So now location also determines the room rates. We've got different methods which now the guest, once they've come into the organization or into the hotel, they are able to make arrangements to clear their bills. We've got the cash system. So this is whereby the guests will settle their accounts via cash. Now, when we talk about cash, we've got different methods of cash. We've got the liquid cash, and also we've got the M-Pesa services. Okay, then we've got personal checks. Personal checks are written in favor of the hotel. Then, of course, we've got the credit card. Now, the credit card, the customer swipes the card, and of course, we've got the direct billing. So now direct billing refers to VIP. Now, the VIP don't need to pay for their bills. So those bills are normally sent directly to the organization where these guests are coming from. So you've got those different types of methods to make payment. Now, we spoke about the accounting. Yeah, you know, at the end of it all, the guest has to make arrangements to leave the organization, and when they're checking out, they have to also to make arrangements for payments. Okay, so under that, we've got what we call a guest bill. Yeah, so a bill is just a document that shows or give details of how much the guest has been able to spend while they were staying at the hotel. Now we've got different methods of checking out the bill. We've got the manual method, whereby in a small hotels, the somebody who will take the sale, each amount that the guest has spent, it is handled separately. We've got a mechanical, now this is meant for medium-sized hotel, and we've got the fully automatic system. Now this one, every time the guest incurs a bill, it is updated into the system. Okay, so we've got those types of guest accounting methods that are used to generate or how you manage bills for guests. Okay, so we've got different types of financial transaction, yeah, in an organization. Yeah, we've got the accounts payable, and we've got the cash transaction. So this is now where we say the guest pays for the cash at the end of the stay. Yeah, so we've got different documents or different documents that actually you get to see in a guest accounting department. We've got the vouchers, we've got the folios, which I think I have given you the notes, and actually I had explained in the last video that we did last week. Then you've got something called the aging account, aging report. Now this generates a report about for a certain period of time that keeps track of all the guests and all the bills that are due and those that are overdue. Okay, yeah, then I remembered I spoke about the credit control. You know, when a guest comes into the organization, we have a department that should be able to take charge, you know, in terms of a guest should not go beyond a certain level. Yeah, there's a department called the credit control, and they've got different objectives that they're supposed to ensure. One of it is to ensure that we avoid and prevent losses due to walkout. Walkout means customers or guests coming into organization and not paying for the services. So we've got common reasons or causes of unpaid account balances. There are reasons why guests would leave the organization or the hotel without making arrangements for payment. So maybe one of it could be maybe they were not explained too clearly the mode of payment when they were checking in. Sometimes their credit cards could have expired. You know, there could also be the issue of negligence from the side of the organization. Okay, so those are some of the causes or reasons that would make guests leave the organization without paying. However, sometimes in a scenario where we receive cash, you know, where we receive cash payment, also we need to have some cash control. So the credit control is in charge to ensure that all the cash that has been received is kept in a safe and ready to be deposited into the bank. Okay, so these are some of the major functions or things that happen in the guest accounting. Now the next lesson that we shall talk about the front office communication. Now the different channels of communication that revolves around the organization of within an hotel. So with those few remarks, thank you so much for having gotten time. So we'll see you in the next audio. Good day.